A short time ago, YouTube user C Baikouzis uploaded a video entitled The Non-Transcendental Exact Value of Pi and the Squaring of the Circle. I've included a link to his video in my video notes below, but I wouldn't count on it being up long after he sees this response. If he sees this response. Believe it or not, Baikouzis thinks he's discovered the true value of pi. That's right. We got another one, boss. And although he found the same value of pi that Mark Wollum derived from his golden ratio, and which I previously proved was wrong, C. Baikouzis says that he arrived at his pi totally independently, and his method, shown here before God and man, is completely unlike anything Wollum did. I guess I've become a magnet for the mathematically challenged pi deniers. But he wanted to know why I have a problem with his math, so here goes. First off, the areas he gives for the circle and square are not equal, unless b equals b squared, implying b equals 1. But since he says b doesn't equal 1, then the circle and the square don't have the same areas, so he really needs to take the squaring the circle part out of his title. Next, on stage left, let's identify the right angle of the inscribed right triangle, and then examine the dimensions marked on this right triangle. Baikouzis labels the hypotenuse C and the right rung B, then he boldly assumes the bottom rung is B squared, without any supporting evidence whatsoever. What I mean by no evidence is that he doesn't show us how he constructed his figure with pencil, straight edge, and compass, so you can't conclude any of the relationships shown are geometrically correct. All this figure is a circle and square thrown on a page with some lines drawn in. This is worse than Wollum's argument, who at least made a half-hearted attempt to confuse his readers with a bunch of hocus-pocus. Yet, Baikouzis says that everything you need to prove the bottom rung is b squared is on this page somewhere. So let's investigate a little further. Now, by definition, the area of a circle is pi r squared. In this example, r is c over 2, so the area of the circle is pi c over 2 quantity squared. Baikouzis sets this area to the value b. He also sets b to pi over 4, which we also know is equal to pi over 4 times c squared. Therefore, c must equal 1, which is great since Baikouzis tells us c squared is 1. So far, so good. But what does any of this have to do with the right triangle? Nothing. It's just a couple of equations equating variable designators to constants. Kind of defeats the whole idea of variables, doesn't it? So, let's start over with what we know. Variable b is equal to pi over 4 times c squared. But since variable c equals a constant, 1, then b equals a constant, pi over 4. Also, b squared equals a constant, pi squared over 16. Does any of this have anything to do with a right triangle? No. Again, it's simply assigning constant values to variables. Now, if the sum of the squares of the two sides equal the square of the hypotenuse, then you have a right triangle. In this case, c squared equals pi squared over 16, quantity squared, plus pi squared over 16, which equals 0.99 something. Since this value is not equal to the given value of c, which is 1, then sides b and b squared don't belong to a right triangle. Not together, anyway. It doesn't mean the value of pi is wrong. It doesn't mean a triangle inscribed inside a circle is not a right triangle. It just means that one or both of the values Baikouzis chose for the legs of his right triangle are wrong. Baikouzis never offered a geometric proof that the bottom rung should be b squared. His only justification for it is that he knows that's what it should be. He can point at B and C and jump up and down all he wants to, but nothing on the right side of this page is proof that the length of the bottom rung is B squared. To find the length of the bottom rung of the inscribed triangle, you start with A squared equals C squared minus B squared. That gives you A equals the square root of the quantity 1 minus pi squared over 16, which is close to B squared, but not close enough to say they are the same value. Amazingly, Baikouzis claims his calculations are totally independent of what Wollum did, yet his equation is exactly the same. He just divided 3 by 4 to the 4th. Seriously, Baikouzis, go back to high school, learn how to do rigorous geometric proofs, and then learn how to argue convincingly.